Hello everyone, it's Vicky and it's a beautiful fall day. A little on the windy side, I may actually be a little windburn. I went running earlier today and it was so windy that my eyes were completely watering. I mean, there was just water pouring out of my eyes. The winds were so intense and so strong. So I may look a little more windburn. Hopefully the light kind of washes me out. But today I'm here to share with you my love for notebooks and journals and diaries, whatever you like to call them. I think many of us share in this obsession, desire, love for, whatever you want to call it. I thought I would share with you, I have been kind of collecting several notebooks, and part of that is mainly you guys are big enablers, which thank you for being enablers. A lot of times you guys share things on Instagram with me, or I go on to Pinterest and I put in basically, you know, daily journals or planners, schedule book. A lot of the Asian influenced type of things have schedule book, and so I love, if you have watched my videos, you know I love any of the like Japanese, Korean, those types of diary pages. I love looking at them, and they have like photos that they incorporate and drawings and things of that nature. So I tend to gravitate more towards those types of notebooks. I love notebooks that are, I think I primarily have all bound notebooks, and then notebooks that lie flat. I really, really love that, those types of notebooks. If you have recommendations after watching this video, please feel free to enable and let me know some more. I have been collecting these notebooks, so this haul is basically since May. I've been collecting different types of notebooks, excuse me, and thought finally I've had enough of them to share some with you and give you ideas. So I'm going to start with smaller and then work my way up to bigger, or however they come. So my first one, I am so beyond excited about these. I found these at Target. Oh, they smell awesome. These books are, of course, I'm not even gonna tell you, I'm gonna show you. Okay, hopefully this zooms in. Bam. Okay, I think we perhaps are like, I don't know, spirits that are connected in the journaling world or something. I don't know. But, you know, I found the Miguel Ruiz book that I made into a Fobonichi. I was at Target and happened to run into these. These were what I thought just regular little like field size notebooks that I like to kind of pop in, but they say they're stone paper, no trees, no water, no bleach, great for outdoor activities, field work, and lab notes. They're water and tear resistant. They have a smooth writing surface. How cool is that? So let me show you. I got these two little designs. These were the only two I could find at Target. I wish they had more, but so they're not made of paper, which I think is so cool, and you can't tear them, which I think is really cool. They definitely wrinkle a bit, but you can actually straighten that out. I just thought this was the coolest concept. I can't even tell you, like, the weight of it, the way that it feels in my hand, it just seems like the neatest notebook I've ever had. And the smell of it is like, you know when you walk into a construction, oh, I think I got lipstick on here. When you walk into a construction zone or construction, like where you smell new construction, when you walk into a house, it smells exactly like that. I don't know why, maybe because it's made of stone. I mean, stone paper, have you guys heard of that before? I think that's really awesome. I think this is so neat. If you see these at Target, pick them up. I want to say they were like $1.50 maybe, or $2. Really, really inexpensive. They have 144 gram, 32 sheets in here. And then it says capture this QR code with your smartphone. I'm going to have to do that and see what it says about it. It just says small journal, stone paper, Barcelona, Spain. So very, very cool. Very neat concept. So I got those just recently. This little book, I am actually not going to open it. I don't like opening my books and journals prior to using them, just because they kind of stay nice on my shelf prior to using them. This is the Iconic Essay Book version 3 in the pink color. I purchased this, I think, from the journal shop. It has like a little leatherette. I did open some of the plastic. It has like a little leatherette cover. And if you look these up, Iconic Essay Book, I'll have, try and find links down below for you. They come in different shapes and sizes and different colors. I like the idea of them because they have all different types of layouts that kind of can prompt different ideas for journaling. So I won't be using this anytime too soon, but I really want to get my hands on it because I thought it was unique enough, and it's in the A6 size, I believe. I mean, it looks like a 4x6 size. So I really, really like it. I'll probably be housing it in one of my little Hobonichi covers, which another obsession for me is covers. Ever since the Hobonichi A5 cousin, like the zipperons, I'm obsessed with finding covers for my notebooks. So I will have that in another video for you guys, just the notebook covers I've been accumulating. But this book, I will have a review for all of you once I start using it, but it's kind of pointless for me to show it to you now because I haven't really even looked at it myself, but wanted to add that in there. Keeping with the smaller notebooks, kind of the field notes size notebooks, I purchased the Moleskin Evernote edition, the small ones. Again, you'll notice it's unopened. I am almost done with my a couple of my Moleskin ones that are the brain dump notebooks. Almost done, so I'm going to be refilling with these very, very soon. I am not new to Evernote, but I'm newer in the sense that since talking to Carrie and Romani, I feel like they really, really use Evernote to its fullest potential. So I'm waiting to see how they set their planners up, which those videos should be coming up in November. Not planners, but kind of the follow-up to the brain dump videos that we did. This is going to be kind of a follow-up in November, and so I want to see how they do it and what they use, and I know they use the Moleskin at the sticker for the Evernote edition. So I picked up a couple of these, and I've seen these at Target, but I just picked these up from Amazon, but I have seen them at Target. Then I love the color of this. It's the Field Notes. They're like the Ice, I think they're called, or Field Notes brand Cold Horizon. That's it. It's just a 3-pack. These are very, very inexpensive. I just really like that blue kind of ombre look that it had on here. And these are pocket-sized, and I got the graph paper because I prefer graph paper when I'm writing and doing notes and things like that. It just makes it easier if I'm making check boxes or anything of that nature. So another one of those. And these I fill up fairly quickly because a lot of it is just note-taking and, you know, things that I find, websites, it's those kinds of things. Let me see. I'm trying to stick to sizes, like working my way up. So these are all the little guys. These are all like Field Note that I've just shown you. Next size up is a kind of a newer size for me, and I consider it, it is a B6 size. So a B6 size is the size in between A6 and A5. I'll show you guys, this is the first one that I purchased. I just got this a couple days ago, and oh, I love it. It smells like plastic. I love it. I think it's the little cover, the little pink cover. So this is a Hello Kitty 2015 diary. I'm slightly disappointed only because I thought this started in November, and for the project that I wanted to use this for, I can't use it until December, which is not all the end of the world because it is the end of October, but I just really wanted to start using it. I will show you guys the book, but I won't tell you what the project is because that'll be coming up next month. I have a really fun project that I'm going to be using this for. I shouldn't say next month, in December, when I actually get to start using it, I will show you. But I bought this by typing in to eBay, B6 schedule book is what I typed in, and these came out. So this is a B6 size. Compared to the Field Notes, you can kind of see how it looks. So this is B6. This is considered, Field Notes. This is that Iconic, which is like an A6, like more of a traditional A6. Size. So just to give you kind of an idea size-wise, but I just like this B6 size. Let me show you. This is kind of an A5. This is like an A5. So just to show you, B6 is definitely kind of an in-betweener. This is just a, I like how it fits in the hand. It's just it's a really good size, and I'm excited to share the project. The inside is really pretty and colorful, lies flat, which is really important. I find that most of the like Korean, Japanese stationery that I purchase, any notebooks, they all lie beautifully flat, which has really become important to me with notebooks. I'll be really honest with you. It's become kind of a necessity for me. I'm really turned off when notebooks don't lie flat for me. So this also came with, let me just show you, this is so cute. Came with a little map, I believe, of Japan, like their transit system. Like we have the L here in Chicago, and I don't know what their transit system is, but it came with like a little map. And then it also came with these adorable, adorable tiny stickers. They're little Hello Kitty stickers. Just adorable. So I'll show you more about this one once I start using it for the project that I'm planning on using it for. But this is a B6 size notebook. Keeping with the B6, I'm going to give you a sneak peek into one of my covers, my obsessive thing, and look how pretty this cover is. Isn't this just gorgeous? I love it. It's true, it's real leather. I love it. I will share this in an upcoming video for you guys. And this houses a B6 notebook as well. I purchased this and I saved, sorry I'm gonna crinkle, but I did save the wrapper because I wanted to share with you. It's a Muji blank notebook and it's 184 sheets. It's in the B6 size, so excuse me. And let me see, this is made in Japan. It has like a craft paper almost cover to it. I really, really love this size. The paper is blank and it's kind of got a yellowish color, very smooth. I'm really excited. I can't read the Japanese. I'm trying to figure out what weight the paper is, but I really, really am excited and can't wait to write on this. It doesn't have a really good book smell to it. There's really no scent to it, but I just enjoy the size oh so much, and I think this is going to be my next like Dear Diary journal because I'm done with my other one, and I just really, really enjoy the size, and I love this little compendia. That's the only name I could find for these like zip arounds. I just love it. I think it just houses my book in there very nicely, and just I love these. I'm obsessed. I'll have a video coming up on these covers, but those are the two B6 size. Now these are the more kind of A5 sizes. The first one that I have here is the Leuchtturm 1917. I'm working on it, guys. I'm working on the proper pronunciation. This is the soft cover large. Now I have a hard cover in the orange, but I use that as my time capsule. And I wanted to try the soft. I wanted to see how the soft covers worked and how they held up. So I'm going to be using this very soon. It's also plain. I've just been feeling the plain notebooks. Ruled notebooks for some reason drive me a little bananas. I just really like it blank because I just want to do what I want to do, and sometimes the lines just prevent me from doing what I want to do in a notebook. So this is a really, really pretty cornflower blue color, and this is in the Leuchtturm, the larger. This is unopened because I'm using this for a project in 2015. So I'm storing it, but wanted to share with you that it was a purchase that I had made. Then I bought, and I always have like extra of these. These are the Moleskine Volant notebooks. I just love these. I picked these up at Target. I can usually find them at Target. Barnes & Noble has them for sure, and Amazon has them. So if you don't have access to a store, you can't get to one. These are in the Slate Gray and Payne's Gray. I really love, love the Volants. These are just my absolute favorite. For just general notes, I keep this in my creme brulee, the wide Midori kind of traveler's notebook from Chic Sparrow. I just go through these fairly quickly because they are on the, they're not too thin. I think they're actually thicker than the K-hairs. I mean, there's two in here. I think they're thicker than the K-hairs, but I just, you fill these quickly if you're doing notes, and I absolutely love those. The next two, these I'm really, really, really excited about because I just recently did a video for you guys for the Productive Lidite, the really big notebook. Well, I went on the site and decided to purchase two of their other notebooks, and they're from the Matte Black collection. So I purchased these two, and I purchased them off of Amazon, so they came with Prime very, very quickly. One of the ones I got was a matte black sketchbook. It's a 5x8, 100 pages, and it says everyday carry notebooks. This is fantastic because it has pages that are numbered, which I absolutely love that about the Productive Lidite. One definite qualm for me is it doesn't lie flat. I've been trying to kind of break up the spine just like I did with a really big notebook to see if that will help it to lie flat, but it doesn't seem to want to lie as flat. But they're great and they're really inexpensive notebooks, and the matte, it's like a matte feeling notebook, which is so neat. I really love that matte cover on there. It just makes it really, really nice. So I'll be using this one pretty soon. And the other one that I got was the Action notebook. It's also an 8x5, 100 pages, and it says everyday carry notebooks. This one's fantastic for those of you that love your bullet journals and you love to-do lists. I love lists. I love bullet journaling. So this is just perfect. It's got the lines. It's already got the bullets in there. And once again, your pages are lined. Down at the bottom, it has a little key for you in the... Never mind what I thought I saw out the window, but it has an open circle action item and a circle kind of... Here, let me show you. down here, just like the key that you have down here that you can follow with the circles, which is great. So you don't have to kind of flip back to the beginning for a legend. It also has kind of the sections up at the top. You can put a date in there, heading, whatever you want to put in there. So really great. You know, I love lists, and it also has an index in here. I love that it has the title page. So you have a title page if lost, that type of a thing, which is fantastic. I just love that. And in the back here, this is really nice. It kind of gives you, almost reminds me of the Hobonichi, where it gives you kind of like, I don't know, this style where they show you all the different matte black collection, which I really like. I don't know, I like kind of having that in the back there. It's really neat. They're very unique. Check them out. I'll have a link down below. I'll try and have links down below for most of the things that I mentioned in here if I can find them. Then moving on to... these I consider more traditional A5 size, I guess. So I guess those weren't really the A5. If that makes any sense. This is the Midori MD notebook, and I got this from Goulet Pens. I did open it, and it has this beautiful like rice paper covering on it, so I'm definitely going to protect that and put it probably into my Hobonichi Cover the Cousin until 2015. That way it's kind of protected in here. I absolutely love the fact that this lies flat. I mean, nothing beats a notebook that lies flat. I love that. I think this is pretty inexpensive. Also, I have to look up the exact price, but I believe it was under 20 bucks, which I think for paper quality and what you get with any kind of the Midori products, I think that's a great price for it. I do wish they would bring back, I saw that there were like the leather covers for them. I wish they would have that, but everywhere that I've gone seems to not have the covers for these Midori MDs. But I'm excited to use this. I have this as well for another project that I have coming up, so I don't want to share too much about what I'm going to be using it for, because I'll have that for a project, that an upcoming project for you. But I did get it in the graph paper, because I do, next to, you know, just a blank notebook, I do really like graph paper. So very, very nice notebook. And then I had to, because you guys are such enablers on the Midori Facebook page, on the Hobonichi page, you guys talked about the Seven Seas Writer on nanamipaper.com. So of course I had to pick up a Seven Seas notebook, and I definitely am very pleased. It lies flat. The one thing I do wish with this was that you could get a blank. I mean, that this would be everything in the whole world if it wasn't lined. Like if this was blank Hobo, or Tomo River paper, like the Hobonichi, I would be in heaven. There are lines in here, which is a little bit of a turnoff for me, because like I shared, I don't love lines, but because it's the Tomo River paper, gotta smell it, there's no smell to it. I absolutely love the Tomo River paper and just how thin it is, how chic it is. I did start drawing in here, and I'll show you, I'm doing like a little, I won't tell you what I'm doing here, but it is kind of a month scan, but I won't tell you what I'm doing with that. But I've stamped in here, and I've used a Coletto, and it's working beautifully. Like, I know how it works on the Tomo River, but had to get kind of one of those. And then last but not least, I did a video on my planner piece and kind of the anxiety that I was feeling and struggling with. And so what I had to do was just put everything away, and I will have an updated video for you on this as well, but this is just kind of a sneak peek to let you know I kind of went back to my simple classic before I can kind of re-enter into all of the planners and kind of get rid of the anxiety. And this is the Leuchtturm 1917 planner, and so I picked one of these up, and I absolutely love it because I love the Leuchtturm notebooks. And so this is just to kind of show you this week for Halloween. I also love these little clips. I'll have to share these little clips with you guys. I picked them up from, I think, Jet Pens, and they're really, really neat little clips. They kind of like slide onto the paper. They're really great little clips. Hold your paper really nicely, but this is a beautiful size. It lies flat for the most part, and the paper quality is just great. I love Leuchtturm for their notebooks. I just love them. I love how they feel in the hand. Like the cover is different from the moleskin. It looks similar to the moleskin, but I'd say it's a lot softer than the moleskin for some reason, and I just love this size. Just going to keep it simple for a little while until I could do away with my planner kind of anxiety before I can reintroduce like a multitude of planners in my life. So I'll have an update for you guys as well on that. And then last but not least, I am most excited about this project. To go along with my sorry, I'm kind of falling off of my bed here. To go along with my planner anxiety, I was on Pinterest and I also kind of was revisiting some of the women. I'm always kind of inspired by people on YouTube and on Pinterest and places like that that have like the home organizer binder, which I do have a home organizer binder, but I kind of wanted something a little bit different, a little twist to it. And of course, I have a video fully about this and what I'm planning with this, but I just wanted to share with you the notebook and kind of how it transformed it. I wanted something that is kind of like a workbook for me, something that I can work out my ideas. You know, once I brain dump something, I kind of need to work out some of those ideas, some projects, some things that I'm doing around the house. I need some place to work them out. When I'm doing YouTube videos, I need to work things out, and I needed something to house all of that. And so I purchased a sketchbook. So this is actually just a regular sketchbook, and what I did was I created my own cover, and then I laminated the cover, cut it, and then fit it in here, just like I did with my customizable spiral notebook video. I did the exact same thing in here, and I will of course share this with you guys, but I put tabs in here, and I have a fall theme, so all of my tabs in here, I'll just quickly show you, are really just all fall themed. But I love that it's sketchbook. I'll show you. The paper in here is beautiful. I got it from Hobby Lobby, and it was very inexpensive, and the paper in here is just so soft. It's plain paper, and it just allows me to really kind of get creative in here for different ideas. So I'll show you like some of my projects and stuff. I can just really kind of work them out in here. And then because I made it the customizable notebook where, you know, I can pop out my dividers, I can kind of move things around in here without worrying, you know, if it was a bound notebook, where I could go in the notebook. So I'll have more on this, but I just wanted to share that I did purchase this sketchbook. It is on the heavier side. This is definitely not something that I'll really be traveling with. It's going to be housed primarily at home, but I love this paper that's in here. It's a great sketchbook that I just picked up at Hobby Lobby and have customized it, and I just really like it and kind of helps my creative juices for some reason. It just kind of has been helping with that. So that is everything, and you guys have helped with some of my shopping. But again, this has been collecting since May. And I shared with you earlier in the video how I kind of get inspired for different types of notebooks for different ideas. I will have a bunch of upcoming videos for all of you. I try and film whenever my daughter is napping, and so I'm kind of limited on that. And I will try and get them up as soon as I can. Thank you all so much for your love, support, and for watching my videos and commenting. I'm just overwhelmed at how awesome all of you are and how kind you all are to me. So thank you so much for that. And thank you so much for watching today. And I'll see you guys again soon. Bye-bye.